हेलो 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 सर, हेलो
हेलो
हेलो हेलो। हाँ यस सर, सर सर रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्ट ही नथिला। आज्ञा सर, मुँ इंट्रोड्यूस कर दूची। ठीक
ठीक
है, आज्ञा। गुड आफ्टरनून लर्नर्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ ओडिशा स्टेट ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज कंप्यूटराइज्ड अकाउंटिंग। ओके, सो कंप्यूटराइज्ड अकाउंटिंग मीन्स व्हाट? इट इज अ सिस्टम दैट हेल्प्स बिजनेस टू मैनेज द बिग फाइनेंशियल ट्रांजेक्शन डाटा रिपोर्ट्स एंड स्टेटमेंट्स विथ हाई एफिशियंसी स्पीड एंड ऑल्सो विथ बेटर एक्यूरेसी। देन व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ कंप्यूटराइज अकाउंटिंग? ओके, द नीड अराइजेज बिकॉज मैनुअल अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम रिक्वायर्स लार्ज स्टोरेज टू कीप अकाउंटिंग रिकॉर्ड्स एंड वाउचर्स। ओके, सो दिस कंप्यूटराइज अकाउंटिंग इट हैज़ नेचुरली द बेनिफिट ऑफ स्पीड, एक्यूरेसी एंड ऑल्सो द लोअर कॉस्ट ऑफ हैंडलिंग द बिजनेस ट्रांजेक्शन। सो रिगार्डिंग दिस टॉपिक वी हैव डॉक्टर प्रदीप कुमार प्रधान सर, फैकल्टी ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस, GM यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड वेलकम सर टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास। एंड आई वेलकम ऑल द लर्नर्स, मिस्टर पृथ्वीराज मिश्रा, सुमिता मैडम टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास। एंड बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू से इफ द लर्नर्स हैव एनी क्वेरीज और क्वेश्चंस, दे कैन आस्क बाय टाइपिंग इट इन द चैट बॉक्स। एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन ऑल योर क्वेरीज विल बी एंसर्ड। एंड ड्यूरिंग द सेशन प्लीज म्यूट ऑल योर माइक्रोफोन्स एंड टू अवॉइड अनयूजुअल डिस्टर्बेंस ड्यूरिंग द सेशन। एंड प्लीज डोंट प्रेजेंट एनीथिंग ऑल्सो। So I would like to request Dr. Pradeep Kumar Panda sir to start the session. Please, sir.
So good afternoon to you. Now we start our block one, part two. Lecture from the last session. And we start with a PowerPoint presentation. Now I'm sharing. Then here is your computer application in accounting. We are in computer fundamentals block one and part two. So starting with from the first unit five. The part two, we first come to the concept that lookup, formula, and printing, translating, and workbook security. All these are included in the Excel worksheet. Then these are the additional formula we need, or which helps us to make our work easy. So, for to discuss. G lookup. There is two of concepts, the G lookup and H lookup. It is very important. You can get question in exam, in assignment also. So first we come to the G lookup. So G lookup is a function performs a vertical lookup. G lookup otherwise known as vertical
hello sir.
Lookup.
Hello sir, may I interrupt? हाँ सर, आपण को ऑडियो टा क्लियर आसुनी टिके।
क्लियर आसुनी?
हाँ सर, बोधे गुटे नॉइज आसुची, बोधे फैन चालू छी सेठी।
हाँ ओके हला
सर टिके। हाँ से जो माइक्रोफोन को टिके क्लोजली आपन यदि कहिबे ताले बेटर टिके सुना जीवो।
हाँ हाँ
प्लीज सर। ओके सर, नाउ इट्स क्लियर। सर नाउ इट्स क्लियर।
ओके ओके सर, नाउ स्टार्टिंग विद द यूनिट 5 लुकअप फार्मूला। द लुकअप फार्मूला स्टार्टिंग टू लुकअप फार्मूला सर देयर इन एमएस एक्सेल। फर्स्ट वी गो टू द बी लुकअप। द बी लुकअप फंक्शन परफॉर्म्स ए vertical lookup by searching a value in the first column of row and returning the value in the same row in the index number position. The VLOOKUP function is a built-in function in Excel that is categorized as lookup or reference function. So, bohi lookup file ami kon koichu na it is lookup or it is searching the value in a column vertically. So when it come to a large worksheet, large Excel sheet, and data are recorded in many columns and many rows, then it is difficult to find out a particular data from the whole sheet at a particular time and a particular data. So when we searching it, we may go for two options. What is the VLOOKUP, one is vertical lookup, and another is the HLOOKUP, which is a horizontal lookup. Sir, VLOOKUP, we go for putting the syntax formula. That is VLOOKUP, area printed, VLOOKUP, column, the first column, we search from the first column of the worksheet, the data, and the corresponding return value in the corresponding column of that same sheet. So here you add to the first column cell and the sheet 2, then maybe go for the next sheet or the third sheet, second sheet, third sheet, likewise. And here is a box, a reference box or reference table from which you give the range of the table. Then we go for the column, searching column from which we get the value. Then we go for false or true. Then we explain it. First one is the first A2. A2 is the roll number. We have taken an example as per your post your book provided by for the course. That is an example. There is a roll number given in worksheets 1 and 2. Then here we describe all the range of tables. Then describe the sheet from the where data is copied. Then we go for the box, describe the range of your table. And 2 the stand for the column number from which data needed. Then false or true stand for the recognize the exact value or identical value or the value nearby values which you need. Then syntax of VLOOKUP is here, go for practical after completing it. The first one is the, then we go to the HLOOKUP. What is HLOOKUP? Now HLOOKUP stands for horizontal lookup. Either lookup means we search in the row of the row value in a row, then it stands for horizontal lookup and can be used to retrieve information from a table by searching a row. Then horizontally, the rows are presented horizontally and the columns are presented vertically. So when we search something in a column, we need vertical lookup or VLOOKUP. When we search a value in the row, then we need for horizontal lookup or to calculate to search a data from the matching data in that corresponding column. So while VLOOKUP searches the value in a column, HLOOKUP searches the value in a row. Very important. Then HLOOKUP gives to the value table, row index, and the range lookup. Already there is a built-in formula in the Excel sheet. I will go to the Excel sheet to calculate that, to show that whether we can calculate that or not. Then here is a table, a preloaded table, Excel table. We will go for searching the data by VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP. Here, the data sheet is here, the large data sheet, large data sheet, and from this data sheet, here the column A, B, C, D up to Q, and the rows are 1 to 18. So, in this data sheet, if you go for VLOOKUP, we put formula directly to count, to calculate the, to identify the value in a column basis. So, when A column, this is the first column, and we can look up value in the first column. Then if you put select first column and you put equal sign, then you D and D replicator coming here, and you got current and parenthesis, and within that hello we put the first the column number what we search, that is the first column. If we found that if you want to column serial number is first, and if we want to calculate or to find out the value of 15 serial number, then you first go for lookup value. There is a formula there, already built-in formula there. First you look up value, then we come to the serial number 15, then you need the table array go for comma, then with the table starts from here. The A2 and by the diagonal will come from the A2 to here your Q 17. Then you first A2, then you go for color, then you go for last cell here Q 17 and Q 18. And comma. Then here you search how which column we need to search with a reference to the first column. For example, if we go for if you want to find out the male number in corresponding VLOOKUP 15, then we go for searching this is the column 1, 2, 3, 4. Four column, we should put 4. And for the exact value, we go for false or you write true or find out the nearby value. So if you write false, then you enter. And automatically count the value 48. And 48 means in the 15 serial number, the male participants in 48. Then you select it. So by putting the formula, here is the small city there. যেটা ছোট সিট অছি আমি দেখি পাৰো যে পাখৰে অছি উই ক্যান ক্যান নট ফাইন্ড দ্য ইম্পৰ্টেন্স অফ দ্য ভি লুক আপ ইন দ্য সিট ইজ ভেৰি স্মল বাট ওয়েন দ্য সিক্স রাইট ইজ ফর আ লার্জ সিট ইজ देयर দেন ইট ইজ ইজিয়ার টু ফাইন্ড আউট বাই দ্য ফর্মুলা হিয়ার সো ওয়েন উই সার্চ আমি যেতিয়া সার্চ কৰিব চাইব প্ৰথম কলম সহিত লিংকেজ ডাটা দেন উই ইউজ ভি লুক আপ দেন ইজ অপোজিট ওয়ে এইচ লুক আপ গিভস ইউ দ্য horizontal data, then we should search is OBC or general or female, then we should search the this row horizontally and to the respective column, row to column and the VLOOKUP column to row. Okay, then this formula is therefore when you put the formula already inbuilt. And when you require to use, you click on that and first you put equal sign and you put the first letter, then automatically it shows the dialog box. From that you choose the formula to calculate the, to find out the value by using that function. Okay. Next we come to the HLOOKUP complete, then we get to the next step. Printing, translating and workbook security. So printing is very simple. When we go for printing, document is ready, then we can go for printing. But printing also needs some setting. While you're printing a document, we need setting like margin, like whether all data, all document is printed in a single sheet or not. Or then printing, while you're printing, we go for some marginal settings like a page setup, like a margin setup, and like we have to see the printing preview, then we can able to make the correct printing and what to print is correctly printed in our paper. So printing is a process of reproducing text and image using current software. So when with the data available in our computer, that will be printed in paper by using printer, and by which function? Now, there are two ways. Every command, every function of computer having two options. Then we can go for by keyboard option command or by mouse. Using mouse, you can also print it. So when you use mouse, you go to file, then you come to print, then you click on the print dialog box, and a dialog box will come, and you select that item, then you go for OK. You get printout of that document. Or in keyboard command, you may directly click on Control plus P, then you can find the printing command. Next, translation. Translation means when a word you need to understand in different language, or you interested to convert into different language, English to Hindi, then you go to the command of the review tab. In the review tab, we found the translation command, and the translation command, we first we select the word which is we know in different language, we are interested to know in different language. When you select that first, then you go for review tab, and click review tab, then you translate, then after translate, you click on the language in which you require to translate, then you get the meaning or the translate value, translate word or the respective word. Then we come to the security. The security is the most important point, that security gives you the restricted access of the document. That is, you may protect or lock the workbook by using password so that cannot be changed or that cannot be copied by others. The process of securing files so that they are inaccessible by other person is called security of document. The document is secured by using passwords. So when you use password, there are two types of protection there. Either you protecting only without password or with password. So when we go for protecting with password, it is more secure. Then others cannot open that file without knowing the password of the document. Okay. Next, we come to the data table and pivot table. The data table and pivot table are the most important part of your analysis of data in Excel sheet. The data table shows a range of cells that used to recording, testing, analyzing outcome on a large scale. It is a way to see how altering the values in formula affects the result. Data table can store the results of multiple scenarios in a spreadsheet and saves you time in calculating multiple formulas. And pivot table is a program tool that allows you to recognize and summarize the selected column and rows of data in a spreadsheet or database table to obtain a detailed report. It does not actually change the spreadsheet or database itself. So it helps us, both the data table and pivot table helps us to analyze data, to setting data so that we can interpret in meaningful way. Okay. Now we go to how here is the data table, and you confirm the data table input many data in different cells, and it becomes a table. And in table, you found the row and columns. The row has some value, and columns have some value. Then you may convert this data sheet to a data table. And when in data table, you go for many functions. Many functions are available there to calculate, to like you go for sum, average, mean, median, mode, elasticity, statistics, standard deviation, many things can be calculated from the data table if you systematically arrange the data in a data table. When you go for practical after completing this, here is the pivot table. The pivot table shown in the picture, you see the left side, last is pivot table, then nearby there is a table. That table is called data table, and the pivot table is in the red circle and the red color. Then the pivot table is converted by the data table is converted into pivot table for easy reference, for easy access, and in a meaningful way. The next after the pivot table, the picture is collected from your book. Then there is a pivot table is converted Here, the screen name. So here is the department designation, employee ID, employee name, age, gender, salary, etc. Here you found the math, physics, botany, geology. Like this, the data are scattered throughout the table, and this table is converted into pivot table, and we found this result. The department is clubbed here, and lecturer, professor, readers, and the female, male, and grand total, etc. It is shown in the pivot table. We go to practical by using our direct Excel sheets. Now we go for the pivot table. Here you see the insert tag. Insert tag will show you the table, data table, and pivot table. The data table, so if I click here, it shows. Here is a dialog box comes, it create table. Then create table, if the table create, already it selected area is there. The from the first to last area total is selected. Then if I click OK, it created a table. Okay, very simple. So when table is created, we can sort data, we can calculate the sum of the data easily. So here we can go for sorting data. You click here, sort A to Z, sort Z to A, sort by color. Then you can find all the options are available here. You can find, you can check the how many elements are there, and you can sort them by using your tick mark or deleting your tick mark. Then if I click here, sort A to Z, then you automatically sort from Anugur to Sambalpur, Subarnapur, sort A to Z. And if I click again, the Z to A, it alternate Z to A. So it is very useful when we convert the data into a data table. And data table makes us easy analysis of the data in the Excel worksheet. Okay, then you come to the back. Again, we insert the pivot table in this data. Then here pivot table is key. Then again, it selects, it takes the selection area. Otherwise, we may change the selection area if you are not interested for the whole data table, whole pivot table. Then you may change it by dragging the position. But if you select the whole table, it's okay. You start an existing worksheet, take pivot table here, okay. Okay, but location is not selected, so it is, I make this, this is the location, and it puts, okay. So here pivot table is created. Here you can count the serial number, district, total, male, female, general, OBC, SCST, undermetric, metric, intermediate. So automatically the table created, and you found the total value, sum of that value automatically by using pivot table. So it helps with the data analysis. But when we go for large data sheets, we need this table to analyze them in a systematic manner. Okay, next we have kids. Okay, then we come to the unit 7, starting with MS PowerPoint. The PowerPoint, I've already we work on that, and you watching the PowerPoint slides here. The PowerPoint is very important tool. It is a complete presentation graphic package. So presentation, while we want to report something, we want to, are interested to show our work to others, to a group, then we need a PowerPoint presentation which gives us the visual and the word data or the document to a large people, large group of people, through PowerPoint presentation. So it is a complete presentation graphic package. It gives you everything you need to produce a professional looking presentation. PowerPoint offers word processing, outlining, drawing, graphics, presentation, management tool, etc. So Starting with the PowerPoint presentation, we have already, I'm already on the PowerPoint, MS PowerPoint 2010. Then here, the use of PowerPoint, how to use PowerPoint. PowerPoint presentation is used to present a person's idea within a few words, and pictures. Second, it is used to describe about projects and related issues of a company. Sometimes if you use PowerPoint in company, PowerPoint is used in every area, like education, like in company, organization, and a presentation of personal views and presentation of, as a student, as a teacher, you can use PowerPoint presentation. And the specific knowledge we need to present the PowerPoint presentation in attractive manner. So if you make it attractive, it is understandable by others easily. And it, if you give it views, good views, then it is also accepted by others quickly. So third is it is required to present profit loss, purchase, sales, and other facts of a business. Fourth, it is also used in teaching and training purpose. Then come to the starting with PowerPoint in 2010. Here is the PowerPoint already running. So here give the picture from your book. That is the Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. It is selected from the start menu, and you will click on the Microsoft Office. Then you found your Microsoft PowerPoint 2010, and if you click here, you found the slides. The slide is here, components of MS PowerPoint. The MS PowerPoint consists of here, you found active home tab, like the other tabs are there, file, then home tab, then insert, then design, likewise. Then you found transition, animations, slideshow, review, view, etc. Then the left side you saw the slides icons, and in the main point of view you get the total slides, and you may go for it the full screen view. Then this is the consist of the middle part, the document area is called slide, and here you write in different manner, like you may change your layout, you may change your background, you may change the color of slides by using your different icons available in the ribbon or in the partner slide. If you go for the new slide, here you check, start a new slide of PowerPoint. Here you can check, this is the blank PowerPoint slide, and here is the slide icon, and here you found the total slides. Click it to title, click it to subtitle, and it is found on the home tab, then insert tab. In insert, you can also go for the inserting picture, clip art, chart, shapes, smart art, anything. You can go for enter here or insert here to make your PowerPoint presentation more attractive. Here you found the text box, header and footer, word art, date and time, slide number, etc. Like we in the other MS Office option Word and Excel. Okay. Then design. In design you found the types of different already templates are available. You can change your slide color, slide design by using your available designs, or you may give a customized design to your PowerPoint slide. Next, transitions. In transitions, you change the style of your presentation. You can change like your post, white, so different styles by which you change your effects of your PowerPoint presentation. Animations, the animation shows the data recorded in the sprites, let's choose animated. Then if you go for the animation, you will make it fade out, fly in, floated, split, wipe, shapes, like this. So many things are there, many types of animations are there. And you go for slideshow. Slideshow tab gives you slideshow from beginning, slideshow from current slide, broadcast slide now, custom slide now, setup slide now, hide slide. Okay, so many options are there. You go for the showing the slideshow by using the slideshow tab. Then review tab, you found spelling check like your Word and Excel, and view to show the zoom form, etc., and available same wise in the Word and Excel. And this one about the your PowerPoint presentation. Next, we go to the unit 4, that is the features of PowerPoint. The features of PowerPoint, it is used to edit, create, and deliver your presentation systematically. It is used to change the background of the PowerPoint for a single slide or for all slides as per suitability. If you need, you can change for all slides, or if you need, you can change for particular background and the font color and many things. Third, it can organize and structure a presentation. Fourth, it can create a professional and consistent format. Fifth, it can animate your slides to give them greater visual impact. Okay, so these are about your PowerPoint presentation and MS PowerPoint 2010. Okay, by this we close our block 1, part 2. Then next slide we go to the block 2. Okay, so if you have doubt from the block 1, you may ask through charts. Okay, now it's set to your block 2. Block 2 is your computerized accounting. Starting from the first slide, unit 1, computer and computerized accounting system. So after the completion of the basic fundamentals of computer about the MS Office, next we come to the basics of the accounting and computerized accounting. So how the accounting is performed, accounting activities, accounting systems, accounting process are performed through computer. That is the computerized accounting. Previously there was no computer and the accounting was manually maintained. Manually means paperwork, pen and paper. Then no doubt we got our work through the manual without using computer. But the computer makes us more handy and more effective while preparing our accounting records. Okay, so starting from the first unit, that is the computer and computerized accounting system. Here is the computer and computer accounting system. A computerized accounting system is an accounting information system that processes the financial transactions and events through computer as per generally accepted accounting principles. GAAP. If you are a commerce student, you know what is GAAP. Now from the plus two onwards, you get GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles, which constitute the ground rules for reporting accounting information. So the generally accepted accounting principles is to process the computer and produce the report as per user's requirement. That is called computerized accounting system. That means it is simple that we have to follow the accounting rules while maintaining the computer accounting system without maintaining the ground rule or whether maintaining the rules and regulation of the accounting. We cannot prepare the true report or effective report of the accounting system. So we have to follow the rules first, then we process it according to that rule to find out the result or to the reports needed by the users of accounting information. So every computer accounting system has two basic requirements. सब कंप्यूटर सिस्टम दुईटा रिक्वायरमेंट्स दरकार गोटे अकाउंटिंग फ्रेमवर्क एना ऑपरेटिंग प्रोसीजर तो अकाउंटिंग फ्रेमवर्क गिव्स अस इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए सेट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स कोडिंग एंड ग्रुपिंग स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड द ऑपरेटिंग प्रोसीजर विच वॉज वेल डिफाइंड इन ऑपरेटिंग प्रोसीजर ब्लेंडेड सुटेबली विथ द ऑपरेटिंग एनवायरमेंट ऑफ द operating system. The requirements for database oriented approach. So, we go to the requirement for database orientation oriented applications. So, when you use the database or process the accounting data through a computer, the computer computer will put the database to the computer and the computer process it. So, we have these four requirements for the application of the accounting in computer. So first of all, we need the front end interface. The front end interface where it is an interactive link or a dialogue between the user and the database oriented software through which the user communicates to the back end database. Okay? So when we process the data through a computer, we need to input. We have to give some data to that. It does not run automatically. First, we need to some data input to the database. Then the data can be processed by the computer. The front end, the database is from front end and the back end. The back end database that is in the back side, in the processor, they process the data. Okay? It is the data storage system. The data is in hidden form, user and response to requirement of the user to the extent of user in authorized to access. The next one is the data processing. But when you input the data to the computer or the system, that process that keep in storage in the database, then that data is processed by the instruction given by the operator. So when we give the instruction for data processing, the data processing takes, it is a sequence of actions that are taken to transform the data into decision useful information. The data can be converted to information. The many data are inputted in the database, and the database processes the data through the needed software and gives you the output, or that output is the processed data. It's called useful information that is needed by us. Then last one is reporting system. Then after processing data, that reports. It is an intricate set of objects that constitute the report. The report is the output of the database, which is useful information. Then we may collect that report from the computer and we transfer it to the users at that information, users at that report. Okay. Then component of computerized accounting system. Okay. The components. So when we use the computer in computerized accounting system, so computer having two parts. We not that means the computer not work without having any assistant from the operator or without software. There are two options. One is the three components, important components, which must you need to work in a computer or work in a computerized accounting system. The first one is hardware. Hardware, you know, this is the physical component of a computer. It is the hardware, is the electronic equipment that includes computer, disk drives, monitors, printers, and the network that connects them. So hardware is the physical component which can be touched and seen. Ame jaha ko dekhi paruchu, ki laptop ho, ki computer ho, ki CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse, internet connection, everything comes under the hardware component. The hardware we must need. Without hardware, software cannot work. And without software, hardware cannot work. Okay? So both are needed. So next we come to software. The software is the set of programs. Software is the set of programs that cause the computer to perform the work desired. So which we need and which types of data we want to process, that depends upon the software. We use that particular software to process the data. For example, if you interested to run a video, then we need video player. There are different types of video players are there. You may play video by using that application. Then softwares are the set of programs that cause a computer to perform desired work. Okay. Next, personal. So personal also very important. That means if you have hardware and software and the system of computers, effective system of computers which both having hardware and software, but if there is no personnel in there, very local ahanti, employees not available. If employees are available but they don't have the computer knowledge, tankara computer knowledge nahi, we cannot perform our work, needed work. So personnel are also the important components of computerized accounting system. Personnel are the critical to the success of endeavor because people operate the system. Without people, it cannot work. It cannot work. Totally kamma pariban. If you have machine, you have all these things, but if you don't have any operator, that then all things having no use. Okay. Here we make a comparison between manual accounting system and computer accounting system. The difference is an important question. What is the difference between manual accounting system and computer accounting system? And if you go through this difference, you can also calculate, you can also write the advantages, disadvantages, like limitations, disadvantages or limitations, advantages or benefits of computerized accounting. So first basis, on the basis of meaning, is the meaning, the manual accounting is a system of accounting that uses physical registered and accounts book for keeping final records. So under manual accounting system, we need to copy, tab, to register, to record our accounting data, accounting transactions in the of the business. But in computer accounting system, what we do, we use accounting softwares like Tally. The accounting softwares that may be ready to use software or maybe a customized software. And software recording financial transactions electronically. So we record in computer account system through softwares to process data easily. Second, recording. In recording manual account system, recording is possible through book of original entry. We go for recording in the book, like we record in journal or in subsidiary books, test book, purchase book, sales book, separately record by the accountant and in pen and paper. But in computer accounting, the data content is recorded in customized database. So here the data is recorded in customized database. You input the data in the software. The database is there, you put the input the data, then computer processes. Okay? Calculation. In manual accounting, the calculation is performed manually by using our arithmetical operation by a human being and by using the accounting process. We process the data from journal to ledger, then ledger to trial balance, then trial balance to trading account, profit loss account, and balance sheet with the financial statement. Manually, we complete it. But in case of computer, only data input is required. The calculation are performed by computer system. Okay? And if the data is entry for the computer, then computer calculator. Computer prepares trial balance. Computer prepares financial statement. Okay, no need to go through the operations that are already fitted in the software. If you input data correctly, that is, if you input data correctly in the perfect place, then computer gives you the correct answer or correct report of your data. Generally, the errors are minimized or maybe very no errors in computer while processing data if the inputs are correct. If the input bhul hela, computer data bhi process bhi bhule kare. The report may be wrong. Then the speed. In speed, the manual accounting is very slow. We are working at the manual system of accounting. We use human brain and we use calculator, etc. And we go for manual calculation. It is a time-taking process and huge clerical works are performed in manual accounting. But in computer accounting, only data are entered, then it works very fast. In a nanosecond, that gives you the results. If you click, that gives us the processed data or the report easily or quickly. Adjusting entry. In manual accounting system, the adjusting entry made for the rectification of the errors. We go for rectification of error or adjusting entry. But in case of complete accounting, it cannot be made for rectification errors. There is no need for rectification error. Only you can enter the data or rectify the data in the input user. But you cannot rectify after data process runs. Backup. In case of manual accounting, no backups are there. Generally, we don't backup it, keep the backup of the data because it is very huge paperwork are there. But in case of computer accounting, the entry of transaction can be saved and backup. If you are interested, I am a Chinese, the data can backup up your pen drive, you can take it in pen drive in a disk. You write it in the disk and you keep it for future reference. And easily make many copies. But in case of manual accounting, it's difficult to make many copies. Or if you interested, it is a huge workload in the of the system. Trial balance. In case of manual accounting, we prepare trial balance when necessary. That means generally always or in the frequently we are not preparing trial balance. Generally it may a certain gap, like after 1 year we prepare trial balance to check the authenticity, arithmetical accuracy of the books of account. But in case of complete accounting, instantly it prepares trial balance. When you click on trial balance, it gives you the result trial balance, but in a second you get the result. But in manual account, it is difficult to prepare trial balance as and when you require immediately. But it may be processed after a certain frequency. Financial statements. It prepared the end of the period or the quarter और हाफ ईयरली और एंड ऑफ द ईयर ଏଇଟା ତିନି ମାସ କିମ୍ବା ଛଅ ମାସ କିମ୍ବା ବର୍ଷ ଶେଷରେ ଆମେ ତିଆରି କରୁ ଫାଇନାନ୍ସିଆଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟମେଣ୍ଟ ବଟ୍ ଦ କମ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟର ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟିଂ ଗିଭ୍ସ ୟୁ ଫାଇନାନ୍ସିଆଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟମେଣ୍ଟ ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ୟୁ ଏଜିଅର୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ଇନ୍ କମ୍ପାରିଜନ୍ ଟୁ ମାନୁଆଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟିଂ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଗିଭ୍ସ ୟୁ ଏ ହ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଡାଟା ପ୍ରସେସ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଭେରି ସିମ୍ପଲ୍ ୱେ ଏ ନୋ ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ ବିକମ୍ ଓଭର୍ ୱାର୍ଡନ୍ ବଟ୍ କମ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟର ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଓଭର୍ ୱାର୍ଡନ୍ ଡିଟୁ enter a vast data in your computer, then it gives you a result without any burden. But in manual account system, when we give more work to an accountant, okay, that accountant may be reluctant to work effectively. It may be full bored, tired to work, use data in manual system. That is simple. It's also very simple. If you know some accounting process and you know the technical part of the computer, then you can use simply and you can get the data. It is integrated method, integrated system. That means everything is found in one click. That means the purchase, sales, your cash book, your ledger, trial balance, financial statement, everything is found. And you go for integrated system, inventory management, your master role, with pay bill, everything is found in an integrated system. It is complete visibility. The complete visibility means at once if you click on a certain result or report in a computer screen, you found everything. But in case of manual paper, we have to go through the searching where that book is available, where that ledger, this number ledger is available. But in computer account system, everything is found on a simple, on a single screen, single monitor. Then it is very, the visibility of the computer accounting is clear than the manual account system. Accuracy and speed. We know the computer processes the data with 100% accuracy. But if the data is correct, if your input is correct, the result must be correct. There is no question about the process, the result of the processed data by a computer. And also it is very fast or very speed. That means picking that correct, that gives you the result by processing in a nanosecond when you go for click on a certain icon. Scalability. Under scalability, it gives us like a handling the software and by using the companies, depending upon the scale operation, we may increase the data level with the same software. Data may increase pariva, kame pariva, they depend upon the scale of operation, we can make it easy to handle. Reliability, it is very reliable. That means we can use the data without any doubt of the report of the processed by the computer.
Audible nahi habar, Khiro. Khiro, audible nahi habar.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. Hello.
Sir, take a microphone. Pakho kune ki kontu.
Achhi, pura pakho dhar dita.
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଆଜ୍ଞା ଇ ପୃଥିବୀରେ ସାର୍ ସେ ଗୋଟେ ଫ୍ୟାନ୍ ଧନୁ ଚାଲୁଛି ହେଥିଲାଗି ଫ୍ୟାନ୍ର ସାଉଣ୍ଡ ଆଡ଼୍ ହେଇଯାଉଛି
ନାଇଁ ତ ଫ୍ୟାନ୍ ତ କାଲି ବି ଚାଲୁଥିଲା ହ୍ୟାଲୋ ମୋତେ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ସ୍ଲୋ ଅଛି ମୋତେ ଲାଗୁଛି
ହଁ ସାର୍ 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 ୟେ ସାର୍ ସାର୍ ଓକେ ଓକେ ସାର୍
ନେଟୱାର୍କ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଅଛି ମୋତେ ଲାଗୁଛି ନେଟ୍ ସ୍ଲୋ ଅଛି
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଆଜ୍ଞା
ମୁଁ ତ ଜିଓରେ ମୁଁ କରୁଛି ତ
ସାର୍
ହଁ ବୁଝିଲ କି
ଆଜ୍ଞା ଟିକେ ନଏଜ୍ ଆସୁଛି
ନଏଜ୍ ରହୁନି ମୁଁ କ'ଣ କରେ
କ୍ଷୀର
ୟେ ସାର୍
ସାର୍
ଆଜ୍ଞା ସାର୍
ହ୍ୟାଲୋ
କହୁନ୍ ସାର୍ ଶୁଣୁଛେ
ହେଲା କି हेलो
हाँ सर
मैच बंद है ना?
हाँ सर कमी लगा किंतु बंद ही नहीं
ना बंद है जीवन का आवाज़ कौन प्रॉब्लम है सुबह का फैन प्रॉब्लम है मतलब
आ गया सर
ओके देखो बट मतलब ये नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम है हेलो
सर
सुबिला
हाँ सर सुबुची किंतु नॉइज़टा कमी गला सर सर यू कंटिन्यू
ओके ओके नाउ वी कम टू द इंप्रूव्ड बिजनेस परफॉर्मेंस द कंप्यूटर अकाउंटिंग इंप्रूव द बिजनेस परफॉर्मेंस बिकॉज इट नीड वेरी लेस नंबर ऑफ ह्यूमन intervention in the system of accounting and it need more and more data processed in a systematic manner and very quickly. The next one is quick decision making. The computer accounting helps us to make decision very quickly as the data are processed in a systematic manner in very fast, then also we can take decision in between the financial year as and when we require. Then storage of data, the data storage also very easily stored in a small chip. The whole data in the large data is stored in a small chip. So computer accounting, which is not possible in the manual accounting system. In manual accounting system, we need many books to record our data and it need storing in a systematic manner so that we can avail the data later on. But in computer accounting, you get all data in a small chip and it is very easy to store. Then cost effective. The next one is the cost effective means the first installation cost is very high in computer accounting system. But the maintenance is very low. So where we use all the computer system of accounting, it will have a cost effective if we use in a large scale business. But generally it is not suitable for small scale business where the micro and small industries are there. It is difficult to maintain a computer account system if the investment is very low. They go for lack of finance for installation of the computer accounting system, but the maintenance is not costly in the system. So these are the various advantages of the computer accounting system. Next we go to the role of limitations of computer accounting system. Disadvantages or limitations. So when we use computer accounting system, we also face some difficulties. The difficulties are, the first one is the cost of training. So when we use computer accounting system, our employees must know the knowledge of computers to work in a computer system of accounting. Otherwise, we have to give some training. हमको ट्रेनिंग दबार अच्छी तो वो है जो ट्रेनिंग वी नीड सम फंड्स टू गिव द ट्रेनिंग एंड टू मेक देम ट्रेन टू ऑपरेट इन ए कंप्यूटराइज्ड एनवायरनमेंट सिस्टम द नेक्स्ट वन इज स्टाफ ऑपोजिशन द स्टाफ्स आर ऑपोजिट टू कंप्यूटर अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम बिकॉज द कंप्यूटर अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम रिड्यूस द स्टाफ द अकाउंटेंट Indian organization while the manual account system need more staff, but computer account system needs trained staff and limited in number. So the old staff of the organization may oppose for the new system or for the introduction of the computer accounting system in the organization. Next, system failure. Sometimes the system may be failure. The system may corrupt may not work perfectly due to any technical errors, due to any mechanical errors. So when it fails, it became a great loss to the organization, which is not possible in case of manual accounting system. Breaches of security. Sometimes the risk of security. So when we use the data that may be copied by others, that may be stolen by others, if the data is stolen, and it can be stolen easily by having hike, by giving, by technical means, by using the internet, by using different communication, electronic communication system. Then there is a risk of security. Then loss of data is another disadvantages. Loss of data means data may be lost when the motherboard or the storage, the secondary storage or primary storage of the computer may be corrupt, or there may be doesn't work, or the when the data, and if the data are already stored and it doesn't work, then there is a lot of chances of loss of all data, and you cannot backup that data easily. Costly for small business. It is very costly for small organization, because the small organization having very small investment, and they could not afford to purchase computers, to purchase the system, and to hire the trained employees for that purpose. Okay, next we come to the role of computers in accounting. Computer is a very important in accounting at the present time. So why we use computers in accounting? We already know that is the recording of transactions. The transactions are recorded in computer accounting, which gives us the processed data very easily. Preparation of trial balance and financial statement. While you recording the transaction in the database process the required data like trial balance. The trial balance is prepared to know the arithmetical accuracy of the books of accounts, and the financial statement also shows the profit and loss position of the business for a given period of time. And the financial statement like balance sheet shows us the asset liability position on the particular date. And it can be easily, and at any point of time, we can check or we can prepare in computerized accounting system, but it is not possible in manual accounting system easily. Financial reporting. The financial reporting also very easy in case of computerized accounting system. When you report this, we can generate the report from the computers or in the software using the computer. Then we can transmit it online system or in the electronic system by mail, etc., to the users of the accounting information. Inventory control. The inventory control are also important parts. The stores control, the inventory or stores is a very important part of the business organization. Then we need to control the inventory stock position of the business systematically in computer accounting system. Payroll management. Payroll also the payment of wages, salary, employees are also needed, and it can be also easily performed for the computer accounting system. So these are the important roles of the computer accounting system in comparison to manual accounting system. Next we come to the factors for installation of a computer accounting system. What are the factors you need to install a computer accounting system? The first one is the scope of business. The scope of business, we need computer accounting system depending upon the scope of business. That means which types of business needed, what types of software. The, like nature of business are differ from place to company to company, business to business, like service sector, like manufacturing, industrial sector. Then different companies need different types of accounting software to process their data. So they may go for the using systematic data as per their necessity. Modules included. Now which part, which modules are included in the required software, that means which are needed by them, that should be customized according to the need of the system, need of the organization. So that also is an important, very important part while you using the computerized accounting system in the organization. The next one is access and portability. So while you access the data, access and portability means easier access. That when you use the computer accounting system, it is very handy. That means all your portability means it is used effectively, and you can transport, you can change it, transfer from one place to another place, and with the handy use, for handy use. Then we require knowledge. The knowledge also very important. If you don't have the effective trained employees to operate the computer account system, you cannot use the computer account system. So we need trained employees for that. Installation operating cost. The last one is the installation operating cost. It is a very important part of a computer accounting system, because installation of a computer account system is somewhat costly. And we also need to operate it by using our technician, by using our trained employees. Then these are the overall factors we need before using our computer accounting system, installation and operation. Okay, these are all about our system, using the computer accounting system in our organization. Then we come to the about the software required for the computer accounting system. The software in computer accounting system, many softwares are available there. Though some are having ready to use, and some are customized and tailored. The classification accounting packages available in different mode, like ready to use. Okay, ready to use means the ready to use software is relatively easier to learn, and people adaptability is very high. It is generally suitable for small business. Ready to use means already the software is complete, and the software directly you load in your system, and you can operate without any change. That means it is adaptability is very high. That means many people are using the ready to use softwares, like you go for the Tally ERP. Then you can use and you can start it. There is no need to convert it, no need to customize it. That is ready to use software. जो ना कि ready है कि थी वो, हमें तब वो install करेगा, हम लोग load करेगा computer में, और we work for it, work in that software. The next one is customized software. The customized software may be customized to meet the special requirement of the users. Sometimes, if the ready to use software do not fulfill our need, यदि सब वो need का हमारे से fulfill करी पाओ नहीं, हमें तो change करें, we go for changing it in a systematic manner so that we can add something to that software, we can delete something from that software to make it user friendly of the concerned person or concerned organization, go for it using as per their own way. So that we customize the software into as per the requirement of the organization. And someone has the tailored software. The tailored software is designed to meet the specific requirements of the users and from an important part of the organization management information system. Any tailored softwares are generally costly softwares, and it is designed to meet the specific requirements of the organization. Generally, these softwares are not available in the open market. Generally, these softwares are created to meet the specific requirements of the particular ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड पर्टिकुलर टास्क ओके पर्टिकुलर टास्क कौन सीटा काम करेगा। देन वी कम टू द सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट। तो व्हाट इज सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट? अ सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट इज द ओरिजिनल रिकॉर्ड कंटेनिंग द डिटेल्स टू सब्सटेंशिएट ए ट्रांजैक्शन एंटर इन एन अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम। सो सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट मीन्स व्हाइल इनपुट गिविंग द इनपुट टू द कंप्यूटर इन द कंप्यूटर अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम वी नीड सम एविडेंस वी नीड सम डॉक्यूमेंट फ्रॉम व्हिच वी इनपुट द डाटा टू द कंप्यूटर। So data is inputted from the evidence or the document available with us. They are known as vouchers. And the vouchers are like cash memo, invoice and bill, receipts, paying slip, checks, debit notes, credit notes, like this. Cash memo means, the cash memo means while we pay money, then we are providing, we get the memo, cash memo. Invoice and bills for purchase and sales, how to invoice and inward invoice, bills, receipts, anything if you receive that recorded in the cash receipts document, where the payment amount is made, recorded, paying slip, checks, checks value payment through check or receive a check, we can record the data, debit note, credit note, we record the third party vouchers which are collected by our organization, like while returning the goods or receive goods from our customers. Then these are the source document. We input the data in the computer account system from these documents known as vouchers. Next we come to the voucher. The voucher, it's important question. Voucher is a document that serves as evidence for a business transaction. Types of voucher. Generally, accounting vouchers are there, and accounting vouchers are the vouchers prepared on the basis of supporting vouchers. Supporting vouchers by accounts clerk or the accountant of the organization, and which are signed by an authorized signature, like payment received, contra sales, purchase voucher, etc. These are the voucher which is generated or prepared from the supporting vouchers. Then supporting vouchers are there. Supporting vouchers means we support for the evidence of any transactions. Like supporting vouchers are the documentary evidence for business transaction which have happened. The supporting vouchers may be two types, internal supporting voucher and external supporting voucher. Okay, for example, when we pay, for example, if we purchase goods for 50,000, if we go for the evidence means you may receive a cash memo or you may receive an invoice, then against that bill, you may go for the payment through a check or through any online transaction. Then that is the record or supporting document for the transaction. Then everything you need to support the transactions made by any person in the organization. So any purchase or any sales of goods, purchase of goods, payment of salary, or any expenditure, you need supporting voucher to make the accounting voucher. Then internal vouchers are generated internally. You cannot record it. It is not important. Internal is generated internally, but the external supporting vouchers are the third-party vouchers. Then the third-party means those who are not related to, those who are related to us, but are the external, outsiders, like our customer, like our suppliers. Then we need some documentary evidence from them, that are the known as external supporting vouchers, like a debit note, credit note, purchase invoice received from the outsiders, from the suppliers, and from the customers are comes under the external supporting vouchers. On the basis upon this, we prepare vouchers and from outside we record the data in the accounting system, and it is the end of our unit one of our block two. And next we discuss in the next class. Okay. Is it clear? Any doubt? Please ask me.
Learners, if you have any doubts, you can please ask.
Learners are requested to prepare and submit the assignments. Kirod?
Yes, sir.
Kirod?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All are requested. All the learners are requested to submit their assignments. And the last date of submission is 14th June. So before due date, all are requested to submit to your nearest study center. And with this, we are ending up this session. And thank you all the learners, and we learned so many things from Dr. Pradeep Kumar Pradhan sir, and we learned V lookup, H lookup, what is a pivot table, and we learned about PowerPoint presentation, which is very much crucial and a very important chapter in terms of applicability and presentation of slides. And then we studied computerized accounting. What is the difference between manual and computerized accounting? What are the benefits of computerized accounting? What is the role of computer in accounting? What are different types of packages or different types of accounting packages? What do you mean by voucher, different types of voucher? So it's a very nice session, and thank you, sir. And thank you all the learners for their patient hearing. And messages are coming that they don't have any doubt, and we understand those sir are teach matlab what sir has taught they understood. One question is there
yes.
What is the difference between data table and a pivot table?
There is no basic difference in data table and pivot table. That data table also table which contains the data, but pivot table gives us the screen data. The data is result is easily available in pivot table. Okay, the pivot table gives us the screen data easily. It is the advanced version. The when the data table also gives us the data, but we use put the formulas to calculate the average. And the average sum, etc., standard deviation, or any descriptive statistics from the data table by using formula, in Excel formula, built-in formula. But the pivot table directly gives you the new table where the data are screened, and you can easily capture the data in pivot table quick manner. Both jaldi hum hai to pivot table. Okay.
Okay, sir, another question. What is the meaning of customized software?
Customized software means those software is prepared for the need of the some specific purpose. For example, if the software ready software available in the market. For example, now we get a software of Google Meet. We are talking here. The Google Meet, then this is software available, freely available in the market, and we can work at, with 100 people, we can offer video calling. But if we need it, now our students have 300 strength, and we need to customize that software to for the 300 people video calling through the Google Meet. Then we customize that software as per our need. That is called the customized software. We change it as per our need. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Any more questions? any more questions from the learner? All are free to ask. Okay, no question.
You can announce the next session also. You can tell them.
Yes, sir. The next session is 28th. Sorry, the next session is. Let me check.
Are you checking, Kirot?
Yes, sir. Sir, the next class is on 30th, that is Management Information System.
No. One class, sorry, is adjusting from his.
Yes, sir. Right, sir. So, sir, the next
class. Whether tomorrow there is a class or not?
Again?
No, sir.
Kali class achi ki nahi?
Nahi, sir. Nahi. Kali nahi. Sir, 30th re gote achi or 31st re gote achi?
Another class we have to adjust, na?
Yes, sir.
Achha, I will talk to Anushman sir. It is possible there are 28-29 classes are not there, na?
28-29. No, sir. No class of computer actually.
Okay, we will try to insert one class in these 2 days. We will try to add it in 29th.
29. Yes, sir.
Let us see.
Talk
to the coordinator.
Okay.
But as on date, they are having classes on 30th and 31st.
30th and 31st. Sir, we will try that one class we would place in on 29th, and if the class will be fixed, then we will let you know all.
We'll let the learners know about the program.
Yes, sir. So, sir, shall we wind up
sure,
for
sir.
Today?
Thank you, Dr. Pradhan. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I mean, and this technical persons are also have done a wonderful job. I also thank both of them.
Learners are requested, and all are requested to please be disconnected or disengaged from the session. Thank you.